Okay, welcome to today's class, children. Today we are going to see two topics, that is magnetic field of earth and magnetic elements of earth. Okay, so examination point of view, it is a important topic. And see, magnetic field of earth. See, it was actually in the year 1600 itself, Sir William Gilbert, okay, he was the first one, okay, to conclude, to say that Earth itself is a huge magnet. Earth is a huge magnet, okay. He was the first person to convey that Earth is a huge magnet. So, how? He concluded based on the following facts. Okay, what is that? Number one, the first one is this. See, if you suspend a bar magnet, okay, freely suspended bar magnet, you suspend it, and you rotate it nicely, rotate it in any direction, okay, and after finally the magnet will come to rest only in the north geographic north south direction. Okay, so when actually whatever you disturb, it is freely suspended and nicely you disturb, okay, rotate, and finally it will definitely come to rest only in the geographic north south direction. And you know very well it is a dipole. This is magnet is nothing but a, what is it? It's a magnetic dipole. It's a magnetic dipole. It has both the north and south poles are there. Okay, and you know that when a dipole, magnetic dipole, is freely suspended, it is kept in a magnetic field, external magnetic field, we have already seen, it experiences a torque. Okay, and what is the function of torque? The torque tends to align the dipole in the direction of the magnetic field, external magnetic field. Okay, this already we have seen. Now coming to this case, when a freely suspended magnet, okay, it is when a magnet is freely suspended and it comes to rest equilibrium only in the north south direction, whatever disturbance you make, you rotate, you whatever you do, finally it will come to north south. It is okay. Therefore, which means this is north, geographic north, and this is, what is a geographic south. Okay, therefore, now, therefore, this is east-west, I think, so here. Okay, therefore, when you are actually east-west direction, right? Therefore, here, so this is the geographic north and this is the geographic south. Okay, therefore, of course, it is east west. Okay, right. Okay. This is okay. Therefore, this is geographic north and this is geographic south. Now, when it is suspended, what happens? It experiences a magnet experiences a torque. Okay, torque, and that is why it is aligned in the direction of some external magnetic field. There should be some external magnetic field here, otherwise why the magnet is coming to rest in a particular direction? Okay, therefore only in the north south direction it is coming to rest, which means that there should be some magnetic field, external magnetic field around the magnet, and that because of that our magnet is experiencing a torque, and hence it aligns the magnet in the direction of the external magnetic field. What is that external magnetic field? That is nothing but Earth's magnetic field. That external magnetic field means, what is it? It is Earth's magnetic field. So you can say that the magnet is suspended in Earth's magnetic field. Because of the Earth's magnetic field, okay, the magnet experiences a torque. And what is the function of torque? That aligns the torque. The torque aligns that aligns a magnet, okay, in the direction of Earth's magnetic field, external Earth's magnetic field. Are you following? Therefore, here this direction where it is coming to, this is the north see, north pole is coming this side. Therefore, this is approximately, it is a geographic north direction. We are taking that as a geographic north direction, and this side is geographic south direction. But actually, a mag, see, is it clear? Therefore, if you take, consider Earth as a magnet, north pole of the magnet will be attracted towards the south. Therefore, magnetic south of the earth will be in this direction, and magnetic north of the earth will be in this direction. Magnetic north of the earth will be in this direction. Are you following? Therefore, that is the reason here is magnetic south and magnetic north. This is the magnetic north. That is the reason why, because here Earth's magnetic north pole is it, that way south comes rest here. It is aligned here. And here, magnetic south pole of the Earth is here. That is why our suspended magnet, north pole of the magnet, will be seeking towards, what is that? Magnetic south. Okay. Therefore, this is a very big evidence, okay, for which actually concludes that Earth is a magnet, as if a very big more magnet is kept along the axis of the axis of rotation of the Earth. It behaves as if a very huge magnet is kept along the axis of rotation of the Earth. Are you following? So this is a number one evidence. Okay, so that made Gilbert to conclude that yes, Earth is a magnet as itself. Earth acts as a magnet. Okay, Earth has a magnetic field around it. And number two, evidence is, see, you take a soft iron piece and it is buried under the Earth's surface. Buried under the Earth's surface, which direction? In the north-south direction. You bury the soft iron core in the north-south direction, and after some time, if you take that soft iron, it acquires the properties of a magnet. It has become a magnet. Okay, therefore, definitely, when a ferromagnetic medium, that is a soft iron, and a soft iron is kept in a strong magnetic field, it becomes a magnet by itself. Okay, this is how bar magnets are made. Bar magnets, how a steel rods are kept inside a solenoid. Okay, solenoid. And if you pass a current, okay, you know that it is kept in a magnetic field inside, that is near the core. Okay, therefore it is the steel is kept in a magnetic field. Okay, and it is, and you pass a strong current. After some time, what happens? If you take out the steel rod, it has become a magnet. Okay, therefore, like that here also, the same thing, when a soft iron is buried under the earth in the north-south direction and it is kept for some time, and if you take out, it acts as a magnet. It has all the properties of a magnet, which means that, what is that? Earth has a magnetic field. This is possible only if external magnetic field is there. Okay. Then another one, there is, you know that when you draw the magnetic field of a bar magnet field lines, there is one point, which is called a neutral point. Okay. Therefore, neutral points, you come across, what are neutral points? Neutral points is where there is no magnetic field. You are drawing a magnetic field of bar magnet, near the magnet itself, you will come across two points either along the axial line or along the either on the axial line or on the equatorial line. You will come across some neutral points. What is a neutral points means? Where, what is that? There is no magnetic field. Okay, how it will become no magnet? Because bar magnet magnetic field is there. It should be there. It is near the bar magnet, but you are getting neutral point. How it is possible? Only there should be some other magnetic field, okay, whose magnitude and direction is equal and opposite to the magnetic field of the bar magnet. There should be some other magnetic field that is present here. Okay, that is nothing but Earth's magnetic field. So, neutral point is a point where magnetic field of bar magnet and the magnetic field of Earth, both are equal and opposite, so that nullified. That is why you are getting a neutral point. So these are all a very strong evidences that says that earth is a magnet. Okay, therefore there is a magnetic field in the earth. Now the branch of physics which deals with the study of magnetism of the earth is what is called terrestrial magnetism, or it is also called geomagnetism. Okay, right. So now this with this evidences, what is the reason then? Okay, this we have got some strong evidences that earth there is a magnetic field. Okay, earth acts as a magnet, but what is the cause of magnetism, earth's magnetism? Now we are going to discuss about cause. So the cause of earth's magnetism, what should be the reason for that? See, okay, William Gilbert has given a very clear idea that earth has a magnetic field. Now what is the reason for this magnetic field? What is the cause? Okay, and there several actually several important postulates in this respect is discussed, actually is given by different scientists. Okay, very important, according to Professor Brackett, one scientist, he told that earth's magnetism, okay, maybe due to, very very important here, maybe due to the rotation of the earth about its own axis, about its own axis. Okay, therefore it is the main reason for earth's magnetic field is nothing but the rotation of the earth about its magnetic, about its axis. Therefore, why, how it will give a magnetic field? Reason is, see, you know that in every every substance on the earth is made up of charged particle. Okay, proton and electrons are there. Therefore, when the earth rotates, okay, these charges produces some equivalent, what is that, circulating currents. Every substances will also rotate now, actually. Therefore, charges will also rotate. Therefore, that gives what is that, rise to current. Okay, therefore it is nothing but circulating current. Okay, circulating current, therefore current carrying coil, it acts as a current carrying coil, and hence there will be some, it produces a magnetic field. Okay, and therefore that is one substance. And another one is, if you go to outer atmosphere, earth's atmosphere, there are so gases are there. Okay, so many gases, and these gases are now in ionized form. Why? Because the reason for this ionization is because of what is the cosmic rays, high energy radiations. Okay, because of those high energy radiations, the gases get ionized. Therefore, there will be ions. It is the outer atmosphere is nothing but it is filled with ions. Okay, therefore, as the earth is rotating, all these ions will also rotate. As the ions are rotating, you know very well, ions are rotating means it acts as a, it produces a current. Once again, that is a circular loop. It acts as a circular loop carrying current. Okay, hence there will be a magnetic field. Okay, the current carrying coil has a magnetic field now. Therefore, like that, so it has a magnetic field. Then other reason is, well, maybe because rotation of the earth means, what should be the reason? What see, the next third assumption is that, see, in the earth's core, means at the center near that, the temperature will be very very high. Okay, therefore extremely hot, and there are several metals are there, that two magnetic metals like materials like iron, nickel, everything are found at the core, but not in the solid state because it is very hot. Therefore, all will be in the molten state. Molten because actually liquid, just like a liquid. Okay, every what is that? The metals like iron, nickel, everything, they are actually because the temperature is very hot, they will be in the liquid form, and the liquid form, okay, and also ionized also. It's hotter. Therefore, there won't be atoms, will definitely at that temperature, very high energy. Therefore, they will get ionized. Therefore, molten ions, IONs, okay, are there at the core of the earth. Okay, therefore, these molten ions, as the earth rotates, this core also rotates, na? Because of that, what happens? There will be a because of that it produces a current. Once again, current loops and hence a strong Earth's magnetic field may be produced because of that. So these are all the different hypotheses that is given. There's a how to take it, whether it is correct or not? Yeah, you can say that. It is supported by the facts, the following facts. What are they? See, now number one, if you see the moon is not having any magnetic field. Okay, why? Because it doesn't have any molten core. It doesn't have any molten core as our earth has. What is that? Lot of molten core is there. Molten core means, as I told you, nickel, iron, and all are in ionized form now. But like that, moon doesn't have any molten core. That is why, what is that? There is no magnetic field. Okay, that is number one. Number two, because as I told you, Brackett was actually, he has suggested that it is because of rotation of the earth about its own axis, I told you, no. So now you see Venus. If you see Venus actually it rotates about its own axis definitely, but in a very slow rate. Okay, therefore the rate of rotation is very slow. Okay, because the rate of rotation is very slow, all it has ions, and therefore the ions, they rotate very slowly, therefore the current produced will be very less. You know that current is rate of flow of charge. Now because the rate of rotation of Venus is very slow, therefore the current, the ions definitely they do circulate, they perform a current loop, but because of the slower rate, the current will be very less and hence the magnetic field will be less. Okay, therefore it has, Venus has a weaker magnetic field. In contrary, Jupiter has the fastest, rotation, rate of rotation. Jupiter, because it is, it rotates very fast, therefore what happens, the current will be very strong. The what it produces a strong, what is a very strong current in the loop. Okay, current loop it produces, but the current will be very strong. Hence what is that magnetic field? You know, B is directly proportional to I, therefore the magnetic field of Jupiter is very very strong. Are you following? So these are all the evidences and the support. See, we are concluding because of these facts. Okay, because of moon doesn't have a magnetic field and it depends upon the rate of rotation, everything, that from that we have concluded, yes, earth is having a magnetic field definitely. Therefore but the magnetic field of earth actually, it is as if, see how it acts, as if a very huge magnet is placed along the axis of rotation of the earth. Okay, therefore how to draw the magnetic field line? Magnetic field lines of, if you see, the magnetic field lines of earth is very much similar to the bar magnet. Magnetic field lines of bar magnet. See, here if you see, this is the bar magnet. Okay, so it is, you see, that we have seen the magnetic field lines, okay, in the last class. Therefore, magnetic field lines of bar magnet, if you keep, I told you how to draw, na? It is a magnetic needle. It is a compass needle is kept. Therefore, it aligns, then you have to put a dot here, then once again you have to put a, keep the magnetic needle, then once again it will align. If you join everything, you will be getting a magnetic field line, I think that I told you. Okay, therefore now this is the magnetic field line of, magnetic field lines of a bar magnet. Now, you see the Earth's magnet, see the Earth acts as if there is a magnet along the axis, this is axis of rotation. This is the axis of rotation. Along this, there will be a magnet is there, but actually there is no magnet. It acts as if there is a huge bar magnet is kept along the axis of rotation. Therefore, see here, this is a north, this is north, and this is south. Yeah. Therefore, from north to south, the field lines will go. Now it is, you see, it is a field line is going from north to south, and it is very much similar to this. You see, this is a bar magnet, and this is Earth's magnetic field lines. So Earth's magnetic field lines resembles very much as a bar magnet. Okay, is it clear? Therefore, this is about Earth's magnetic field. Hope you are able to understand this. Okay, right. Next topic is magnetic elements of earth. Okay, elements of what is that? Magnetic elements of earth. Now, what are they? What is magnetic elements? See, the magnetic. I'll get define first. Okay, after that I'll explain. See, the magnetic elements of earth at a place. It has to be defined at a place. Okay. So, magnetic elements of earth at a place are, it is elements, not element. Okay, therefore, magnetic elements of earth at a place are the quantities, okay, that describe completely, okay, the both magnitude and direction of earth's magnetic field at that place. Okay, therefore, what is that? Magnetic elements of earth at a place are the quantities which describes both magnitude and direction of earth's magnetic field at that place. At that place. Okay. So, now we are going to see what are the earth's magnetic elements. They are, see, number one, first one. First one is magnetic declination. Very important topic. Magnetic declination. That is represented by theta. Number two. Magnetic dip. Dip. Or it is also called magnetic inclination. Okay. And third one is, and how to represent delta. Usually it is represented by delta. The third one is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Is it clear? Therefore, now we are going to see one by one what is it. Number first one is magnetic declination. See, what is magnetic declination? Just now I think in the magnetic field I told you a freely suspended magnet. Okay, a magnet is suspended by means of very very thin silk thread. Okay, therefore, and now actually we say that it points out geographic north south, but I told you that time it's approximately magnetic north south, geographic north south. It is exactly, see, I told you we are taking north pole of the suspended magnet. Okay, it actually points towards north. We are taking now. It is points towards north. And south pole of the magnet points towards geographic south. Like that we are, this is approximation. Actually, this is approximation. Why? Because actually, see here, when I am suspending a magnetic dipole, that is a magnetic needle. Okay, so it is coming in equilibrium in this direction. This is the direction. This is the direction. Okay. But actually the geographic north is there. No? Geographic north is exactly not in the same along the axis of the magnet. But slightly geographic axis. This is your geographic north and this is the geographic south. Usually we are considering that wherever the north direction of the north pole of the magnet is pointed, that is the geographic north direction. Usually we are taking that, but actually that is an approximation. Actually, okay, your geographic north will be slightly, what is that, this approximate only, slightly, what is that, in this direction, geographic north here, but your magnet is aligned in this direction. Are you following? Which says that, see, when it is aligned in this direction, the magnetic needle is aligned in this direction, you know that it experiences a torque because of that. What is it? It is aligned in the direction of the external magnetic field. So external magnetic, what is the external magnetic? Earth's magnetic field. Earth's magnetic field, north pole is coming to rest in this direction, means there should be Earth's magnetic south pole should be here. So in along this direction, what is that? Your Earth's magnetic south pole is here. And along this direction, because south pole of the magnet is pointing, it will be attracted towards the north, the magnetic north pole of the Earth. Therefore, Earth's magnetic north pole is in this direction. That is why south pole of the magnet is attracted by the magnetic north pole of the Earth. Are you following? So this axis, therefore the axis of, that is the magnet, this axis is, they know that is what is called, this is axis, huh? This is what is called the magnetic axis. Magnetic axis, are you following? But actually your south, it is your geographic north is exactly not in this direction, slightly varied. Here is your geographic north and here is your geographic south. Okay, actually we are considering that wherever the needle, north pole of the needle points, it is the north direction. Actually it is not, it's approximate. Actually there will be slight variation. Okay, therefore this is your north pole of the, this is north pole direction where the north pole of the suspended magnet it points out, but your geographic north will be slightly different in this direction. Okay, therefore this is axis, therefore the axis that connects the geographic north and south is nothing but the axis of rotation of the Earth. There's nothing but axis of rotation of the Earth, and this is what is called your geographic axis. This is what is called the geographic axis. Okay, therefore listen, magnet, when the, once again the magnet is suspended, okay, therefore the magnet will align in the direction of the Earth's field. The Earth's field is such that the north pole of the magnet will be towards the magnetic south of Earth, okay, and south pole of the suspended magnet will be towards the magnetic north pole of the Earth. Correct? Therefore the axis, okay, connecting south and north pole of the magnet, if you extend that, that will be your magnetic axis. Okay, magnetic axis. Why? Somewhere here Earth south is here, magnetic south is here. Somewhere here, what is that? Earth's magnetic north is here. So if you connect both, that gives you what is called the magnetic axis. And axis of rotation of the Earth is there, no, that is nothing but the geographic axis. That is, are you following? Therefore this is your geographic north direction and this is your geographic south pole. Therefore the line connecting both, that will be geographic axis. Hope you are following. Now only I'm going to come to magnetic declination. Now what is magnetic declination? Magnetic declination is nothing but, okay, the angle, a small angle between the magnetic axis and the geographic axis. A small angle between the magnetic axis and the geographic axis. Therefore, this one is what is called theta. This is theta. The angle, small angle between the magnetic axis and the geographic axis. Are you following? So, I want to, once again, I want to give one more definition. See here. See. Okay. This is the same thing first I'll give you here. See, this is the Earth. Okay, therefore Earth's north pole magnet, Earth acts as a magnet whose north pole is here and whose south pole, at south pole, magnetic south pole is here. Okay, it is Earth's, see, I'll give you with some other See, this is Earth's magnetic north pole and this is Earth's magnetic south pole. Therefore, that is why it is given magnetic north, Earth's magnetic north here and Earth's magnetic south here. Okay, but Earth is rotating about this side. This is axis of rotation. This is axis of rotation. Okay, like that. Therefore, this should be geographic north. This should be geographic north. Are you following? Geographic north, and here it is geographic south. Magnetic north, where magnetic north is there, that direction will be geographic south. Okay, but these both the axes, this is your geographic axis and this is your magnetic axis, and both are inclined at small angle. That angle is what is called your what is that? A declination, magnetic declination. Okay, right. Now I am going to give you, see, I told you one more definition. What is that? See, this is your magnetic, see here, if you take this one, this line is there, no, this line, this is nothing but your magnetic axis. Magnet is suspended, it aligns like that, and this is your geography axis. See here, compare this. This is your magnetic axis, this line is there, no, this is your magnetic axis, and this is your which axis? Geographic axis, no? Therefore, that is represented here. This magnetic axis, geographic axis, the angle between that is what is called angle of declination. But now, see, what is, now I want to give the same in terms of magnetic meridian and geographic meridian. What do you mean by magnetic meridian and geographic meridian? See, the vertical plane containing magnetic, this is the magnetic axis. This is your magnetic axis. Are you following? So, the vertical plane containing the magnetic axis is what is called magnetic meridian. Are you following? The vertical plane containing the magnetic axis is what is called magnetic meridian. Therefore, if you keep this by A, is kato. B is field, therefore you give some A dash. Okay, so and is it clear? This plane A dash C D is there, no? That is your magnetic meridian. Okay, like that, the vertical plane containing geographic axis. Geographic axis kya hota hai isme? A B dash. Okay, the A B dash, the vertical plane, this plane A B dash C dash D hai na? Okay, that is your, what is the geographic meridian? Are you following? A plane, vertical plane containing magnetic axis is magnetic meridian, and a vertical plane containing geographic axis, this is geographic axis. Geographic axis is what is called geographic meridian. Geographic meridian. Are you following? Therefore, what is angle of declination? Angle of declination is, one more definition is, the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian. Geographic meridian kya hota hai isme? A, B dash, C dash, D. Okay, magnetic meridian A dash, C, D. Therefore, the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian is what is called theta. Is what is called theta, that is angle of declination. So, angle of declination is angle between geographic axis and magnetic axis, or it is the angle between the geographic meridian and magnetic meridian. What is magnetic meridian? Magnetic meridian is a vertical plane containing magnetic axis is what is called magnetic meridian. A vertical plane containing geographic axis is what is called geographic meridian. Is it clear? Right. With this, therefore first is over. What is that? Magnetic declination. I think, hope you understand this. Next one is magnetic dip. Next one is, what is magnetic dip? So how to explain magnetic dip? See here, magnetic dip is nothing but, or magnetic inclination, it is also at a place, it changes from place to place. That is very, very important. Okay, whether it is magnetic declination, magnetic dip, everything, it changes from place to place. Therefore, the magnetic dip or magnetic inclination at a place is defined as, okay, the angle, okay, between angle between the direction of the total magnetic field of the earth, earth's total magnetic field, and a horizontal line drawn in the magnetic meridian. Horizontal line drawn in the magnetic meridian is nothing but magnetic axis na? Magnetic axis. Are you following? Okay, therefore what is that? It is, once again I will come back to this, this is very very important picture. Okay, with respect to you, you are supposed to draw everything in your classwork. Okay, this diagram is very very important. Okay, therefore let me zoom it. See here, this is what is here, what is your magnetic dip or magnetic inclination at a place, okay, is defined as the angle between earth's total magnetic field, direction of earth's total magnetic field is B, direction of earth's total magnetic field, and the horizontal line drawn in a magnetic meridian. What is horizontal line drawn in a magnetic meridian? Is nothing but magnetic axis. Magnetic axis. Are you following? So the angle between magnetic axis and the total earth's magnetic field is what is called magnetic dip or magnetic inclination, delta. Hope you are following. This is full A dash C D is magnetic meridian. A B dash C dash D is what is that? Geographic meridian. The angle between these two is what is called angle of declination. Now next one is angle of dip or angle of inclination. It is the angle between earth's total magnetic field and the horizontal line drawn in a magnetic meridian. Or what is the horizontal line drawn in a magnetic meridian? You can say it is magnetic axis. Okay, therefore you can say that it is the angle between the direction of the total magnetic field of the earth and the magnetic axis, that is what is called angle of dip. This angle of dip actually, you know, this also varies from place to place. Place to place. Okay. So, for example, if you say, what is the angle of dip? Angle of dip actually at the poles, near the poles. Okay. South pole, north pole, whatever, near the poles. Okay. The angle of dip, delta, that is equal to 90 degrees. It is maximum. That is the maximum angle. Angle of dip is 90 degree near the poles, okay, north pole, south pole, wherever, okay, and it is at the equator, it is a magnetic poles, it is magnetic poles, okay, magnetic poles here, what is that, here it is delta, that is equal to 90 degree near poles, okay, and equator, magnetic equator, delta, that is at equators, magnetic equator, okay, delta, that is equal to, what is that, it is zero, delta, that is equal to zero. So at the poles, delta angle is 90, and at equator it is zero. Very important. Okay, dip angle is equal to zero, and all the other places it varies from 0 to 90. At all the other places it varies from 0 to 90. Are you following? Therefore, now see here how to measure this dip. How to measure the dip at any point? See, for that only. See, there is one. What is called dip circle is used. I have, I think. See here. This is, you see, it is a magnetic axis, and here it is theta. Geographic theta. Magnetic axis. And here it is the geographic axis. Okay. Therefore, between that it is theta. Therefore, that is okay. It is a magnetic needle. Okay. Magnetic needle is coming in this direction. Therefore, angle between magnetic axis and geographic axis is what is called magnetic declination that you need. Okay. Now, dip circle. Okay. What is dip circle? Okay. Whether I think you have understood this one. Okay, therefore this is a magnetic needle, so it is a magnetic axis, and this is a geographic axis. Angle between them is what is called angle of declination. Now what is required here is this one. See, it is a dip circle. this is the dip circle. Okay, so this automatically measures the dip angle at any place. As I told you, at different places, the dip angle varies. Okay, therefore, for example, if you say the dip angle at Delhi is 42 degrees below the horizontal. This is horizontal, 0, 0, hai na? Wo to horizontal hai. Therefore, below the horizontal, it is 42 degrees below the horizontal is what is the dip angle at Delhi. Is what is called dip circle. This is what is called dip circle for measuring dip angle at any place. Okay, right. With this, shall we come to the third one? Let me go. Required, that is fine. You cut it now, I think you have an idea about it. Right. Now, let me go to the third one. Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Okay. Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field means, see here. Okay, that may be required. Anyhow, I'll draw this one, no problem. See here. It is magnetic recall that one A dash okay C D and this is magnetic axis. I'll draw that because there is some problem with that. Was not okay. Okay, this is A, I think we have taken it B dash. Why? The B is meant for magnetic field, that is why I don't want to use B here. And it is C dash. So, this is your magnetic meridian. Okay, and this is your geographic meridian. Okay. And this is A, B dash is geographic axis, A dash is magnetic axis. Okay, not only A dash, any line, if you are drawing like this, any line, this is nothing but magnetic axis only. Okay, a vertical plane containing the magnetic axis is what is called magnetic meridian. Okay, therefore, now you tell me now what is the angle of declination here. The angle of declination is, okay, this is theta. This angle is theta, correct? This angle is theta. And now what is angle delta here? Delta is, see, if I have the angle between Earth's total magnetic field is this. For example, I am taking this X field is, my total magnetic field is this direction. Okay, therefore, angle between Earth's total magnetic field and the horizontal line drawn in the magnetic meridian or a magnetic axis, that is A dash, that is your delta, correct? Okay, therefore now you know this one. Now third one is, what is horizontal, third is the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. What is that? See, it is, if I, B is the total magnetic field, no? If I resolve this magnetic field into two components, okay, therefore, how to resolve? See, I'm resolving B. Okay, this. Okay, this is nothing but your the angle. Okay, A, you give L. A, L is there, no? A, L is what is called, okay, BH. Okay, it is a component of B along magnetic axis. Component of the total, what is horizontal component here? That is why I'm telling you, horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is nothing but it is a component of total magnetic field of Earth, okay, along the horizontal line drawn in the magnetic meridian. It is the component of total Earth's magnetic field along the magnetic axis. Along the magnetic axis, okay, magnetic axis A dash, no? There, what is the component? That component is A L, na? That is nothing because your A इसका तो वो करो सम, ये वो इज योर टोटल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. आई एम रिजॉल्विंग इनटू टू, वन इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक एक्सिस, दैट इज ए एल. ओ ए एल का नाम क्या है, ए एल वेक्टर इज नथिंग बट बी एच. ओके दैट इज बी एच, बी एच, दैट बी एच इज नथिंग बट हॉरिजॉन्टल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ अर्थ्स मैग्नेटिक, इट इज अ हॉरिजॉन्टल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ अर्थ्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. बी एच इज हॉरिजॉन्टल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ अर्थ्स मैग्नेटिक. एंड वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट क्या होता है इसमें, वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट सी है ना, यम, इसका यम करो. एंड दिस वन इज बी वर्टिकल, ये यम है ना, दैट फील्ड ए एम, दैट इज अ नथिंग बट इट इज अ वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ अर्थ्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. Okay, so you have idea about horizontal and vertical component of Earth's field. Okay, right, but because now I have done that with a drawn with a red line, but it will be difficult for you, but I don't know, just kindly bear it. Okay, because therefore what is that red is not that visible, you told me, but anyhow I have forgotten, here I have written, drawn this diagram, see that. Okay, therefore AM that is equal to BV. AM that is equal to BV vertical component, and AL is nothing but the horizontal component. What is how to define horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field? Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is nothing but the component of total Earth's field, okay, in the direction of the magnetic axis of the Earth, or in the direction of horizontal line drawn in the magnetic meridian of the Earth. Is it clear? Okay. Therefore, now you come to therefore. What is now, as I told you, BH is known, horizontal vertical components are known now. Okay, therefore how do you give the magnitude of BH? What is magnitude? Magnitude AL na, magnitude AL, that length gives you, what is that, magnitude of horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. AM gives you the magnitude of vertical component of magnetic field, direction as shown here is given. Okay, therefore BH, what is BH? BH from this, B is this, therefore what should be BH? AL, AL should be, I think you know, B cos delta, hai na, B cos delta. And what is your BV? BV that is equal to B sin delta, that is a vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, vertical component of Earth's magnetic field. Is it clear? Therefore if you, this is equation number 1 and equation number 2, it is horizontal component of Earth, and here it is vertical component of Earth's magnetic field. Therefore, if you square and add both, equation 1 squared plus 2 squared gives you, what is that? BH squared plus BV squared, that is equal to B squared into sine squared delta plus cos squared delta. Therefore, your, what is therefore sin squared delta plus cos squared delta? I think you know these things. One, therefore, what is your B? B, that is total Earth's magnetic field. Total Earth's magnetic field is nothing but BH squared, horizontal component squared plus vertical component squared, BY squared. Is it clear? Okay, therefore, this is a very important relation. Earth's, how Earth's field and its component are related. Okay, therefore, this is equation number 3. Right, now you equation 2 by 1, equation 2 by 1 gives you, what is it, BV by BH, that is equal to tan delta, that is equal to tan delta. Are you following? Therefore this gives you the dip angle, dip angle at any region. If you have idea about vertical and horizontal component of field in that place, BV by BH, that gives you what is the angle of dip. Okay, right. Therefore now very important here is, as I told you, B, what is B, BV, BV that is equal to B into sine delta, na? Okay, so in the special cases, see, BV that is equal to B into sin delta. Okay, so when at the place, see, when delta, that is where, when at vertical, at poles, okay, at poles, I told you, at poles, magnetic poles, delta value that is equal to 90 degree, I told you. okay? Therefore, delta 90 means what is your total B? B that is equal to B V value, correct? B is equal to total magnetic field will be the vertical component value. Okay, therefore, what is your horizontal component? Therefore, at poles, delta that is equal to at equator. Okay, now I'll tell you, don't go to equator now. See, at poles, delta that is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, therefore, what do you say about your horizontal component? Horizontal component of Earth's field, BH, isme kya hai? At poles, mein le, I'm telling. Okay, what is BH? BH, that is equal to B into cos 90 ho jayega na? Therefore, that is equal to 0. Therefore, total magnetic field one will be, what is that? Nothing but the vertical component only. Okay, but horizontal component at pole, that is equal to 0. At poles, there is no horizontal component. Okay, always Earth will have a horizontal component everywhere except at poles, magnetic poles. It is magnetic poles. At magnetic poles, okay, every total Earth's field will be only vertical component only. Total vertical component. Total vertical component will be the total Earth's magnetic field. Their horizontal component will be equal to 0. Very, very important. Okay, here very interesting thing happened. See, a freely suspended magnet at the pole. Okay, if a magnet is freely suspended at the pole, okay, it will stand vertical. It will stand vertical with its north pole pointing towards Earth's geographical north. Exactly, geographical north, okay, and vice versa. Geographical north means magnetic south is there. Are you following? Once again, when it is freely suspended, when a magnet is freely suspended at the poles only, vertical component is only there, horizontal component nahi hai. Therefore, what it will do? The magnet will stand vertically with its north pole pointing towards geographic north. Okay, geographic north mein kya hai? Magnetic south and vice versa. Okay, so this is about at poles. And now what will happen at equator? At equator, what will happen? See, you're at equator, your delta, what is your delta? Delta that is equal to 0, already I told you. Okay, at equator delta 0, pole is delta 90, and all the other places it will vary from 0 to 90. I told you, and dip angle. Okay, so delta that is equal to 0 hai na? Therefore, delta 0 hai. So, what is your BV? Therefore, BV vertical component will be equal to 0. But, what is your BH? BH is equal to B cos 0 hai na? B cos delta. That is equal to B cos 0. That is equal to B. That is equal to B. Are you following? Therefore, total at equator, total magnetic field will be the horizontal component. Total magnetic field will be the horizontal component only. Okay. Therefore, its vertical component equator is 0. So, Earth will have, everywhere there will be vertical component will be there except that one place where equator there is no vertical component. Vertical component will be equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, how the magnet, freely suspended magnet in the equator will stand horizontal. Will stand horizontal. Are you following? But in the poles, it will, I told you, it will stand vertical. Okay. But here it will horizontally it will be oriented. Hope you are following, children. Okay, right. So with this, now we will go to some problems. Okay, we'll see two problems here. At a place, the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is BH, and the angle of dip is 60 degrees. What is the value of horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at the equator? At the equator. Okay. Therefore, it is given that at a place the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is BH and the angle of dip is also given. Delta is given. Delta that is equal to 60 degrees is given. Okay. And therefore you know that at that place BH is equal to B into cos delta. BH that is equal to B into cos delta. Okay. Therefore delta is 60 degrees. Okay. Therefore you know that BH that is equal to B cos 60 half or B by 2. Okay. Therefore what is Earth's total magnetic field? B. B is Earth's total magnetic field in terms of the horizontal component at that place. Correct? Therefore B that is equal to 2 into BH. What is BH? BH is a magnetic field, horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at any place. Okay, right. But you, so now I have got the Earth's field, total field in terms of the horizontal component in that place. Right. Now, but what is asked? What is the value of horizontal component of Earth's field at the equator? Therefore, at the equator, at the equator. Okay, I should have used some other pen color. Okay, at equator. What is your delta? Delta is equal to 0. Delta that is equal to 0. Therefore, you know that, okay, BH, what is your BH? BH that is equal to B into cos delta. Delta usme kya hai? 0 hai. Are you following? Therefore, BH ka horizontal component let. BH dash, because I have already used BH for horizontal component in any place. Okay, BH here, let me write. Let BH, yes, the horizontal component at a place. Okay, here BH dash. Okay, is the horizontal component where at the equator. Okay, BH is the horizontal component at the equator. Are you following? So there is no space. BH dash is the horizontal component at the equator. Therefore, how do you BH dash is equal to B into cos 0 hai? Okay, therefore, what is B here? B in terms of horizontal component at that place 2BH. Therefore, you can say BH dash that is equal to B, to 2BH AB into cos 0. Are you following? Therefore, your BH dash is equal to 2BH. BH dash is equal to 2BH. Are you following? Is it clear? So, you are given the horizontal component at some other place where the dip angle is 60 degrees. From that, you are asked to find a horizontal component at the equator. Therefore, delta that is equal to 60. Therefore, what is the horizontal component? What is the total magnetic field? Total magnetic field at every place will be the same. Okay. Total magnetic field at every place will be the same. Therefore, find out first what is the total magnetic field. Total map only the horizontal vertical component only varies from place to place. Therefore, total magnetic field you find it. Once your total magnetic field in terms of the horizontal component at that place is ready. Now you are asked to find out the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at the equator. Equator mein to angle delta dip angle is 0. Therefore BH dash is the horizontal component at the equator. Therefore BH dash is equal to once again B into cos delta is 0. Therefore BH dash is equal, which means that BH dash that is equal to B. B kya hota hai? 2BH hota hai. Therefore, BH dash is equal to 2BH. Is it clear? Right. Next one. Next problem. You see. Horizontal component of Earth's field at a place is 0.4 into 10 power minus 4 joule. Okay. If delta is equal to 45. Delta. See everything. If delta means angle of dip is 45 degrees. Find the total Earth's magnetic field and the vertical component of Earth's field. Okay. So, what are all the things given here? Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is given as 0.4 into 10 power minus 4 Tesla. Right. And delta that is equal to 45 degrees. Okay. You are asked for what is your BV is equal to what and total magnetic field that is equal to what. Okay. So I think easily you can find out BV by using the formula. You know that BV by BH is equal to, that is equal to tan delta, hai na? Already you have seen, no? Tan delta. Okay, that is nothing but tan 45. Tan 45 degree. Which means tan 45 is 1, no? Therefore, your BV by BH is equal to 1. Therefore, BV that is equal to BH, and that is nothing but 0.4 into 10 power minus 4 Tesla. Okay, therefore vertical component, horizontal component both are same. Okay, right. Therefore, what is your B? Therefore, this is your BH value you have found out. Now, what is B? You know that B that is equal to B that is equal to, oh, you know BH that is equal to B into cos delta, hai na? From that, if you find B is equal to B H by cos delta, are you following? B H by cos delta. Therefore, that is nothing but, what is your B H? 0.4 into 10 power minus 4 cos delta cos 45. Okay, therefore, what is cos 45? 1 by root 2. Therefore, you will be getting, it is, that is equal to 0.4 into 10 power minus 4 divided by 1 divided by root 2. Therefore, what is your B? B that is equal to 0.4 into root 2. Okay, into 10 power minus 4 Tesla. Okay, if you calculate, value of B will be 0.56 into 10 power minus 4 Tesla.